I've got a fun idea, and that involves finding a crow. It might take a while to figure it out, but we'll find it. In fact, that might be it way over there on the fence. Once we find it, we can harvest its feathers and use those for new items. Before we get carried away, let's fix the crap I blew up last time with all my bombs. And cut down a bunch of grass while we're waiting for night to fall. Do you mind? I'm hitting stuff. And yes, this would be a lot quicker with the bombs, but I'm not sure the bombs count. Because I'm trying to unlock a mutation right now, and to do that, I just need to cut down grass. That's not a bad start for today. Anyways, now that it's morning, let's try and find the bird. I think I can actually see it. It basically came to me while I was making food this morning. Getting to it might be a little bit difficult at this point. I don't even think I can shoot my arrows that far, but hopefully it drops me a feather at some point. I can see my arrows do actually go that far, but they don't seem to interact with it. I will try and plant some bombs on it at some point, but it might take a while to figure that out. It's blown away over the house, and I didn't notice if it dropped any feathers because I wasn't texting or anything. Not seeing any feathers, but what a surprise, I'm doing grounded wrong. I'm also going to be killing a lot of these today because I'm going to need a lot of spider silk for many different things. And the big spiders too, why not? Come on, nice and easy. I feel like they're slightly tougher with this new update. These ones still aren't much trouble, but the bigger ones might be. Have you ever wondered if ladybugs can explode?
I know I have.
Whoop, easy now. Hey there. Insect. Yeah, those actually do a lot of damage to ladybugs. I don't know why I haven't been blowing them up this entire time. It takes like 3 bombs and then I can hit them with a hammer. Yeah, I know. Whine about it. We all die sometime. No wonder you idiots get stuck everywhere so often. Here, you earned this. Eat the bomb. There you go. Oh, didn't really work. Oh, kind of worked. And yeah, I probably could be finding a better use for these bombs, but for now, I'm going to enjoy them. I know how to get more. Oh, it tripped over the bomb. That was perfect. I didn't think that was actually going to hit it. I've already collected enough berries to repair my armor, so now I'm just looking for the bird and cutting grass for the time being. And now that I think about it, I'm going to need lots of arrows because I need to kill lots of things with a bow and arrow. That way I can upgrade bow and arrow damage. I can hear the crow cawing to me. It's somewhere in this direction, so we're going to see. There it is. It's back on top. Idiot, please drop me a feather. And it left without dropping a feather again. So I guess it's just back to my project for today. I got my first mutation, Grassmaster. My intimate knowledge of chopping grass makes me chop grass faster. Excitingly, that looks something like this. And yes, I have also now learned that I can repair my tools. All it takes is 2 pieces of quartzite, or 5 in this case. Either way, that's way easier than building a new tool. Because I can get a lot of quartzite from the ant colony, and I spend a lot of time down there anyways. Does anybody need any grass? So far, all of this was still only enough to get me 1 level up. And today, I'm heading back to the berry bushes because I need mite fuzz, and apparently I can find a feather there. So I'm going to be killing a lot of these morons. But also using my bow and arrow to do it, because the more things I kill with the bow and arrow, the more damage I do. And I kind of want to be able to do a lot of damage. I apparently got another mutation for exploring stuff. Not really sure what that one does at this point, but I'll take it. Well, there's no bird here right now, but there is some science points and one of these things that I mostly ignore. I think this spider's broken. I don't think it can move from where it's at, so I'm free to sit here and smash it in the face as much as I want. And I kind of wanted to see if there's any update to this place, and it doesn't look like it. We do have another spider that's pretty stuck. Not sure what this is. I'm gonna kill it. A water flea. Sir, please don't go too far with my arrows. I need those back. Dramatic much? So water flea meat. All right, well, at least I can eat it. And I got another mutation, cardio fan. I assume that's just some running around so much. Wow, I'm happy to see the crow and all, but it could have placed itself a little bit closer to me. Still waiting on even one feather, by the way. And it left. Didn't drop a feather. So that's fun. I'm obviously doing something wrong again. I'm not really sure how I got here. I swam through a random cave I found in the water. And, yep. I feel as though there's supposed to be something here. But we'll worry about that later. I gotta find my way out of here. I'm also gonna check my favorite ant colony ever, because apparently you can once in a while find a feather down here. Along, of course, with some eggs that I can use for bombs. Those ones have already hatched. Should get to these earlier in the day. They clearly know I'm coming for them at this point. No feathers, no anything. How is this for a bad spot to be? There is a wolf spider waiting on top of my waterhole. I've realized now that what I need to do is use a few of these grass planks to make a tower. That way I can actually see where the bird is on any given day, because it's kind of hard to find it. So I'm going to spend just a little bit of time doing that. That way I can actually find the damn bird. It's not going to be the prettiest thing in the world, but it's only going to take grass to build it. Once I'm up adequately high enough, I'm going to throw a few of these down. That way I have a little platform to stand on. Then I can check if the bird is there, or up on this laser, or over at the bird bath, or somewhere up on that fence, and wherever else it might be able to show up. Hilariously, the bird is right back where it was this morning, where it didn't leave me a feather, at the bird bath, so we're gonna wander all the way over there to check. One feather, that's all I'm asking for. I think I finally found what I'm looking for. It wasn't exactly where I expected it, but the first crow feather.
axe.
So we're hit it with the axe and see what we get out of it. I thought I might have to start getting creative. Okay, good. We did find one. One crow piece. We'll go ahead and analyze this. That was a long walk. So the feather turns into both the marksman's cap and feather arrow. And as you can see, the marksman's cap is the only tier 3 armor. And it of course adds to the bow attack. The only problem is I need 5 berry leathers and 3 crow feathers. That's gonna take me 10 years to find, but I'm gonna do it because I want the damage. If I combine that cap with upgraded bow skill along with the feather arrows, I think I'll be doing quite a bit of damage. This is my life now. I'm gonna climb up here, wait for the crow to appear somewhere, make my way over to it, hopefully find a feather, rinse and repeat, while bow and arrowing everything I can find along the way. Speaking of which, sharpshooter. You'll increase damage with all bow type weapons, and I didn't realize I've actually got to equip these. I can do 3 at a time. So for now I'm gonna do this one. I think that makes me move a little faster, and this one which makes me regenerate stamina faster. I didn't even realize that Morin was up there. It's not making any sound. I was just wandering around looking for stuff to kill. I waited all this time for it to fly away and not drop a single thing. At least the ants are gonna have lots of food. Of course you're back at the bird bath, because that's furthest away from me. But this could be a good damage test. Still need more. I want to be able to one-shot these guys with a bow and arrow. Currently it takes me 3 arrows to kill an ant, so if I can get it down to 1, that would be great. And no feather. Kinda wondering if the crow is leaving any feathers up top there. I've seen it on the picnic table a few times, but I can't get up there currently. I might build my way up because I have nothing better to do anyway. Alright, it's a fresh day. Let's wander our way up there. And since I'm gonna need a lot of grass, we're gonna undo the damage perk and put on the grass cutting perk. That way, grass still takes 3 hits to cut down. But I'm pretty sure that by the time I'm done this project, we'll have it leveled up in that skill and probably have a few more feathers waiting for us somewhere out in the world. This little project is even taking longer than I thought it would. But if I can finish it by the end of today, I will consider that a success. The most time-consuming part at this point is running up and down again and again and again. Oh good, a friendly wolf spider came to help me out. Yeah, you better run. Just gotta make a bit of a corner at this point and figure out how we're gonna go up the rest of it. That looks like it'll work, only a few more pieces of grass to go. Alright, I had to add a few more, but that brings us to the top where there's conveniently no feathers waiting for us. But at least we get to see the top of the picnic table. And that was still more fun than sitting there waiting for feathers to fall off of this stupid bird. This could be a fun place to set up a fortress. Well, that was fun. Let's go see if the bird has left us something somewhere else. I've got a fun idea. But I'm gonna have to assume that the feather arrow is very good because it takes a crow feather to make. So we're gonna settle for that for now. And then we can do a little damage comparison. We just need a volunteer. Remember when this world used to be crawling with ants? No, there is none. Finally found one. Alright, so if you could hold still, a regular arrow without damage boost does about a third of its health, maybe a little better. So now if we switch to my single feather arrow apparently, we're going to hope that it's amazing because we only made 1 arrow. I thought we'd make at least 4 or 5 given that we're sacrificing an entire feather to make it, but I guess we'll see. Here's my next volunteer, right in the face, and it does almost 2/3, well a little over half the health. So it's an improvement, but not necessarily a huge one. Not sure that's worth the sacrifice of a feather. And that was with damage boost on, so we could probably one-shot an ant if we had enough damage boost the next 2 levels, but we're not quite there yet. But that tells me the potential is there, because I could get 2 more levels of damage boost, plus the feather hood, which will add more damage. But for now, I think I'm still better off going like this. Actually, my bow and arrow does about as much damage as the mint mallet does. So it's going to be more damage than this thing, I just need more arrows and more damage. And then on top of that, I'm actually really nervous to fire this arrow because if it gets stuck in an enemy, I'm never going to see it again. So we're just going to go ahead and do it anyway. Didn't even do a lot of damage to that bombardier beetle. So we'll just kind of jump in and finish it off the manual way. I don't know how I would ever get a full quiver of these arrows, but with enough time, I guess I can do anything. I can definitely see how with a full quiver of arrows and the full damage, it could be a really good setup, but until I have that, this is gonna happen a lot. Does anyone out there know the drop rate of the feathers? If you do, let me know. Because so far, it seems like it must be 5 or 10%. It hasn't been any higher than that for me. I hope it likes the platform I built for it.
I'm gonna walk my way up there and manually pluck those feathers right off that stupid bird.
Yeah, I understand that the feathers drop off from the rear of the bird, so if it does drop any here, they should land on top of the picnic table. You're standing in the way, my friend. I really hate this bird. It's actually blocking my way up. And it left. I didn't even get a chance to hit it. And of course, no feather. Look at that. Been running around so much, I got another cardio upgrade. Cardio fan is now level 2. Level 3 is the highest, and I'll get there eventually. Alright, so here's the deal today. Since these stupid feathers are taking many hours to acquire, I'm gonna go check over there. And I'm going to base my next intelligent decision on whether or not there is a feather there. Just as I suspected. I get here, there is no feathers, but the bird is back from where I left. Sometimes the game just doesn't want to play ball. Still, no feather anywhere to be found.